Hi guys, this is Akash and today's video is about Tughlakabad Fort. So before I start, I will share with you how to get tickets booked for this fort and the location from the Google Maps where the fort is located and how to access the fort by public transport. So as you can see, this is the Archaeological Survey of India site. You need to select Delhi as your city, monument as Tughlakabad, and then you need to select the date or which you want to visit and the time, and just move the next arrow. Here you will see the nationality Indians, foreigner, BIMSTEC, SARC, all of which will have different prices. So you need to enter how many adults are going and the ID proof, passport, PAN card, driving license, voter ID or others. And then you need to fill your email ID. And then just pay through your digital wallet. Now in the map, you can see at Google Maps, the location of Tughlakabad Fort and the timing shown as 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. And as you will zoom out, you can see different localities near Tughlakabad, and it is at Badarpur Mehroli Road. You can also see the people rating about this place, recent comments. And now we'll show you a satellite view of the location. You can see the location is totally green and it is very vast. One cannot see the whole fort from just the outside while driving by. Also, now I'll show you how to access this place through metro. So the nearest metro station is Tughlakabad metro station, which is at Badarpur, almost Badarpur border. And from here you can see 4.5 kilometers is the distance. So depending on the time, the fare of auto will be there, maybe 60 to 100 varying. And because this video is recorded at a convenient time, so the time is showing us 9 minutes. It might vary about 20 to 25 minutes depending on the local traffic. Now I will show you how to drive by if you are going by your own car, vehicle. So this is your Panchsheel Road, from Panchsheel towards GK, and one can drive by. As I was traveling at early morning around 8:30, so the traffic on the roads was very less. Yes, it was pretty bright, sunny, but there was no traffic. तुगलाबाद, गियाथुद्दीन तुगलक, AD 1321-25, आफ्टर असेंडिंग द थ्रोन ऑफ डेली, सेलेक्टेड दिस साइट एज हिज कैपिटल फॉर स्ट्रैटेजिक रीजन ही बिल्ड ड्यूरिंग AD 1321-23. अ मैसिव फोर्ट अराउंड द कैपिटल सिटी विच स्टैंड्स हाई ऑन सीक्रेट आउटक्रॉप्स ऑफ अ रॉकी हिल. The fort is roughly octagonal on plain with a perimeter of 8.5 kilometers. It's 1,07,015 meters. High rubble built walls are provided with bastions and gates at intervals. The rampart walls are pierced with loopholes and are crowned with a line of rude battlements of solid stones, which are also provided with loopholes. Presently, the fort has 13 gates and there are 13 inner gates to the citadel. The vast size of great strength and the visible solidity of the whole, gigantic in proportion and strength, give to the fort an air of stern and massive grandeur. Tughlabad was divided mainly into three portions. To the east of this entrance, a rectangular area with high walls and bastions served as citadel. A wider area immediately to its west, similarly bounded by rubble walls and bastions, housed the places. Beyond this, to the north, lay the city, now marked by ruins of houses. Streets in the city, some of which are legible even now, ran in a grid pattern from gates on one side to those on the opposite side. Inside the citadel enclosure area, tower known as Vijay Mandal and remains of several halls, including a long underground passage. The fort also contained 7 tanks amidst ruins of several large buildings. To the south of the fort outside was a vast reservoir created by erecting bunds between hills. A causeway connects it with the tomb of Ghiyathuddin Tughlaq, while an embankment near its southeastern corner gave access to the fortress of Adilabad, built a little later opposite to its another hill. Tughlabad Fort is a ruined fort in Delhi, built by Ghiyas-ud-Din Tughlaq, the founder of Tughlaq dynasty of Delhi Sultanate of India in 1321, as he established the third historic city of Delhi, which was later abandoned in 1327. It lends its name to the nearby Tughlaqabad residential commercial area as well as Tughlabad institutional area. Tughlaq also built Qutub Badarpur Road, which connected the city to the Grand Trunk Road. The road is now known as Mehrauli Badarpur Road. The entry fee for the fort is rupees 20 for Indians. Also nearby is Dr. Karni Singh Shooting Range and Okhla Industrial Area. Surroundings are an important biodiversity area within the Northern Aravali Leopard Wildlife Corridor, stretching from Sariska Tiger Reserve to Delhi. Historical place around sanctuary are Badkal Lake, 6 km northeast, 10th century ancient Surajkund Reservoir and Anagpur Dam, Damdam Lake, Tughlakabad Fort and Adilabad Ruins, both in Delhi. It is contiguous to seasonal waterfall in Pali, Duhaj, Kot villages of Faridabad. The sacred Managar Bani and the Asola Bhatti Wildlife Sanctuary. History. Ghazi Malik was a feudatory of Khalji ruler of Delhi, India. Khalji dynasty is Muslim dynasty which ruled India. Once, while on a walk with his Khalji master, Ghazi Malik suggested that the king build a fort on a hill rock in southern portion of Delhi. The king jokingly told Ghazi Malik to build the fort himself when he would become king. In 1321, Ghazi Malik drove away Khiljis and assumed the title of Ghiyas-ud-Din Tughlaq. Starting the Tughlaq dynasty, he immediately started the construction of his fabled city, which he dreamt as an impregnable yet beautiful fort to keep away the Mongol marauders. However, destiny would not be as he would have liked. The curse of Nizamuddin Aulia. Ghiyas-ud-Din is usually perceived as a liberal ruler. However, he was so passionate about his dream fort that he issued a dictate that all laborers in Delhi must work on his fort. Saint Nizamuddin Aulia, a Sufi mystic, got incensed as the work on his Bauli well was stopped. The confrontation between Sufi saint and the royal emperor has become a legend in India. The saint uttered a curse which was so to resonate throughout history right until today. The death of ruler. Another of the saint curses was Hunuz Dili Dur Ast. Delhi is still far away. The emperor was engrossed in a campaign in Bengal at that time. He was successful and was his way to Delhi. However, his son Muhammad bin Tughlaq met him at Kara in Uttar Pradesh. Allegedly, at the prince's orders, Shamiana tent was made to fall on the emperor, who was cursed to death in 1324. Tughlakabad is still consists of remarkable massive stone fortification that surrounded the irregular ground plain of the city. The sloping, rubble-filled city walls are typical feature of monuments of Tughlaq dynasty. Are between 10 and 15 meters high, topped by battlemented parapets and strengthened by circular bastions of up to 2 stories height. The city is supposed to once had as many as 52 gates, of which only 13 remains today. The fortified city contained several rainwater tanks. Tughlakabad is divided into 3 parts. The wider city area with houses built along rectangular grids between its gates. The citadel with a tower at its highest point as Vijay Mandal and the remain of several halls and a long underground passage. The adjacent palaces area containing the royal residences, a long underground passage below the tower still remains. Today, most of the city is inaccessible during the dense, thorny vegetation, and every increasing part of the former city area is occupied by modern settlement, especially in the wind city of its lakes. South of Tughlaqabad was a vast artificial water reservoir within the fortified outpost of Ghiyath al-Din Tughlaq Tomb. This well-preserved mausoleum remains connected to the fort by 11 elevated causeway that still stands today. Well, visible in the southeast are the remains of fortress of Adilabad, built years later by Ghiyathuddin's successor, Muhammad Tughlaq, 1325-1351, which shares the main characteristics of construction with Tughlaqabad fort.